check us out at exposingrealityradio.com.
Loosen up, you guys.
Is Out of the Shadows.
What up, everybody? Landon here. I'm joined today by Sean Cohen and Jerry Emery of the Paranormal Response Team. What's up, guys?
What's going on?
What's up?
Woo! Another beautiful Saturday. Yeah, another episode. How y'all doing?
I'm doing good.
I'll be doing good in a minute when I get to the bottom of this Guinness 200th anniversary export stout.
There you go.
As we see, we got two Lushes and one guy over here drinking responsibly.
Look, Sean's the only one that doesn't want to drink while we do this.
Well, hell, you know, I got a 30-mile ride to go home, too.
Yeah,
little thing called paranoia.
Well, let me go home in front of you since I go, mine's a shorter drive on the same road, so that way if you see me somewhere on the side, you can stop and... Hey, Jerry.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure that'll go over real well.
Yeah. Hey, I had to have a margarita. Cinco de Mayo, man.
Yeah, screw Cinco de Mayo.
Cinco de Mayo is,
an American
holiday. Here we go.
It's an American holiday. That's all it is.
No, it isn't. It is an actual Mexican holiday, but most people think that it is the Mexican Independence Day, which it is not.
It's like Day of the Dead or something?
The 16th of September. Is the Mexican Independence Day.
Is that where Mexico was liberated from Texas, California, and...
16th of September is the anniversary of the Battle of Puebla, which is what made Mexico an independent nation.
From who?
Spain or France.
I figure it was where, you know, Teddy Roosevelt sent the army down there and We took Texas.
No, we're talking about times of Maximilian and shit.
So oh, okay.
It's.
I'm just being a smart ass.
Okay. Well, you know, some things never change.
No, this is true.
So what the hell is
Sean's about a then? Smart ass and I'm an old curmudgeon. It's a perfect mix.
I didn't understand a word you just said, but okay.
So what is what is Cinco de Mayo then?
Cinco de Mayo?
It's just fucking made up out of nothing?
No, I think it's just a bunch of gringos getting drunk.
Holiday, but I can't remember the whole thing behind it because, you know, my ex, she was Mexican and she instructed me that one time that Cinco de Mayo is not our Independence Day. And she went into the whole thing about 16th of September and I didn't give a shit about Cinco de Mayo. So.
All I gotta say is build a wall. Welcome to America.
By the way, folks, I should neglect to say that this room is pretty much full of paraconservatives.
You know, I named the episode ParaWhore. Right? You guys know about this yet?
No, I'm trying to figure out the name for ParaWhore.
I know Sean, for the most part, he stays out of all the drama.
She's the right? A pair of horse, the one that gives all of her money to the pair of pimp.
That's what we need. We need pair of pimp shirts. Yes! Oh my God, that's genius. You know, Nick...
I can't take credit for that. I think that came out of Dave Miller's mouth first.
Oh, did it?
Or Richard Wade, one of the two. Okay. I saw it somewhere already, though.
Bastards always taking the good ideas.
Well, we can always step it up, you know, a little further, you know, just get a fuzzy... what's those hats they wear? Fedoras?
A fedora?
Yeah.
You that's know, not a fuzzy hat, is
you know
it?
What I'm talking about? Just like a pimp hat, you know, come out with some goldfish in your shoes or whatever.
Oh, well...
Of course, it's not my generation. Jerry will know more about this.
Have you been watching too much I'm Gonna Get You
Sucker? Yes, I did.
Where are the goldfish shoes? Gotta have a pair of those.
Yes, you do.
I've got to give credit. You know, Nick Riggs from Paranormal Disorder.
Yes.
You know they're from Salt Lake City, Utah, right?
Yeah.
So he made a t-shirt. I don't know if you saw this. But it says, Para... And then on the bottom it says SL for Salt Lake City, and right. Then UT for Utah. It says Para Slut. All because of this fucking para drama, dude. Over this para horse shirt.
OMG, Jesus Christ.
He put it, so if you guys want to get one of those, if this was not a joke, I think it was legit. I'm actually going to look it up right now. You can visit paranormaldisorder.com, and you can get one of those, because I'm definitely going to.
That is actually pretty funny. It's always nice making fun of someone else, you know. You know, they want to cause all the drama and they wonder why everybody picks on them at one time.
Oh my God, it was so good. I saw it, dude. I was dying laughing.
So is that what you're looking up right now?
Yeah, no, I'm trying to stay out of all of it anymore. I mean, since I went off on my rant the other day on Facebook, I'm just trying to stay in them, out of the middle of all of the drama anymore. Because I just...
Well, see, that's the problem. You know, Facebook's great, but, you know, I don't think you should ever rant on it. You want to have a rant, have a good old-fashioned way, go over there, just bust something in their mouth, then leave.
Come on, nobody does that shit anymore.
Oh, come on, it's like going trying to pick women up. Everybody wants to do it online now. You know,
breaking the law, I almost had
my idea. He didn't put it up. It had to have been a joke that he put up, because it's not on his store. Damn you, Nick Riggs. I know you're not going to listen to this, but damn you. I would totally want one of those shirts.
So, is that what he's selling now?
Oh, wait, hold on, there's a second. There it is. Look at that! It is up there. Let me see if I turn.
Hey, they even got wife beaters in them too.
I think it's just a woman's shirt. $20. There you go, guys. You want a Paraslut shirt? ParanormalDisorder.com. You can get you a Paraslut shirt. I'm definitely gonna do that.
But I got a question. Why are we online and doing this live broadcast and you're soliciting somebody else?
Right, I was gonna say, why not?
You know, why are you soliciting somebody else? You need to be soliciting us.
Look, Paranormal Disorder is one of our sponsors.
How's it one of our sponsors?
Because we're a sponsor for them, they're a sponsor for us. We support each other. We're supporting Para Unity here.
Para Unity. I'd rather see a Para Slut.
You're a slut. Oh my God. I can't believe people get so fucking upset.
Oh, that is freaking
over
awesome.
A stupid t-shirt.
I told you
that
what
is
I
awesome.
I want a pair of panties.
Pair of panties, huh?
Yeah. Better start thinking about some abbreviations for that one.
Oh my God. What is wrong with us?
Oh.
I know what's wrong with me. I can't vouch for you guys.
Well, I wouldn't admit it. So.
I honestly just don't give a shit.
There you go. We opened up with some Guns N' Roses. How'd you like that brand new Guns N' Roses outfit?
Axl Rose still sucks. He's very nasally when he sings. The only thing that made that song would have been Slash, if he's even playing guitar for him.
I don't know. I really don't know. All I know is it came out this week, so I figured
I still think he sounds like somebody's twisting his warbles when he's singing.
I'm not a fan, but dude, how old are those guys? I mean, they're like stupid old, right?
I'd say they're probably in their late 50s.
Be very careful.
They're probably in their late 50s right about now.
But they're selling out everything that they do for like ridiculous amounts of money.
Oh, I get that, you know, like, but if you look at their fan base, is they're in their early to late 50s.
Okay, but listen to that song.
I was careful, Jerry.
Jerry's like giving us a death look over here. But hearing that song, do you think that their fans are going to be supportive of that? I mean, because they're pretty much, most of their songs, people like them because they're nostalgic and they take them back to another time. But now that you're putting out new music, is it still going to be something that they're going to
be? Sure, Pink Floyd did it until they finally had so many members of the band that died that they couldn't do it anymore. You know, the Stones? Come on. Sure. Grateful Dead?
But you're talking about a totally different class of generation of rock.
Not really.
Yes, you are.
They overlapped each other by a large bit. Man, you cannot tell me that Pink Floyd was not still popular when Guns N' Roses
was Pink Floyd was still popular when I was in high school.
Okay.
Okay. And I graduated in 92.
I mean, the genre is a little different, but not the era so much.
You know, it's just a different age of hippie. You know, you had your 60 hippies from Free Love. You had today's hitter piece, which you want to call gutter kids. And all they want to do is get a free handout from somebody. Don't know what the true hippie is.
Okay.
You know, this Guns N' Roses, every time I hear this thing, I'm thinking of redneck rock. I'm thinking of a trailer park, single wide trailer park, and with a third generation Camaro.
Every time I hear Guns N' Roses, my thought goes back to Southern Indiana. Where the Klan still is.
I wouldn't go that far. I wasn't going there.
Well, I am. I grew up there, and I can tell you.
Jerry but, taking it to the extreme.
But also, too.
Southern Indiana.
And
is
I'm pretty
the
sure they have their trailers with their wheels still on it with no underpinning.
It's still the most backwards area of the country.
But it's okay if the underpinning's there, right?
Yeah, well, it'll be fine. It's a livable habitat. And they probably got a third generation Camaro sitting out in the yard with weeds growing up around it.
You just can't take the wheels off the trailer.
Just don't take the wheels because you might have to move.
Why not?
It all depends on how you want to repossess the trailer, too. You wake up one morning, you open up your door, and you see your welcome mat gone. You're in a world of shit.
No big deal to take the wheels off of it because it probably doesn't have a skirt on it anyway.
Well, it depends on what you want to talk about a skirt. Well, what's up with you talking about panties and skirt? You been late since the bicentennial?
I think I have been since the bicentennial,
yeah. Okay, I'm just making sure, okay? You know, at the rate I'm going with my 12 years of marriage, you know what I'm saying?
Hey,
anything that walks down the street looking good right now.
You got to remember, it's been probably 4 months since me and my wife split, and longer than that since we were really split.
Are you really split?
You know, a good stiff breeze right now would make a weather vane.
Now, back to this current post. What is going on, guys?
Let me go ahead and throw this out there. For any of you guys listening, we do have a call-in line today. If you guys do want to, you know, throw your 2 cents out there, all you have to do is call 423-520-6239, and you can get on air with us. That's 423-520-6239. We're here to answer any questions you got. You want to talk some shit to us, you're welcome to do that as well.
Yeah, come on, bring it on.
I know Sean would love that.
Well, about the only thing you'll get out of Jerry's mouth is this, you know, the only thing he'll say is, go fuck yourself. So.
No, you will say that. Jerry won't say that. He'll argue with him.
No.
No, he'll argue. Don't
that he? One's going into the book of fuckeries.
I just don't give a fuck.
Hey, well, what do you guys think of this? They came out with a new Tremors movie.
What they
think it's like number four or six. I can't remember.
No, they had five.
So it is six.
Yeah, it has to be six.
Number six.
I actually saw some pretty good reviews for it.
Really?
Really.
Yeah. And there's actually a couple good actors in it from what I hear. I don't remember who it was.
Well, I'd like to see a good classic come back is Critters.
Critters? I've never even seen that.
Oh, yeah.